So I'm gonna try and not be terrible at vlogging in the spirit of Vlogmas, I suppose. I'm gonna do some more liberty training with Arrow before it gets warm. Have my giant bottle of water. Then we're gonna go and visit Barry at the hospital. Barry's in hospital again. He's okay. I'll fill you in later. Have you been let down by the ones before? Do you live too soon to know? Never fell in love, 'cause I just got loose. But not when it comes to you. You're very cute. It would be nice if we kept it clean for more than 24 hours, but whatever. Whatever floats your boat, mate. So last video, I jumped Arrow at liberty. You might have seen that. Today we're just gonna do some more basic stuff. I might try jumping her again at liberty later this week. Also, if this video gets enough likes and comments, I will write her tack list this week. And she's never been written tack list before. Later today, Arrow's also getting acupuncture because she's the best girl. Got a new tripod and it's already getting wobbly. So Arrow's having some acupuncture later today. If you didn't see the last video, she's on holidays now, so she's not doing any like proper ridden work or anything. She's just gonna have some chill time after Wallaby Hill. She doesn't really like chill time though. She really likes to work and do things. So we're doing like the liberty and the fun stuff. I might also take her to the beach. Good girl. Might also take her to the beach and like trail riding and stuff. So hopefully I can film some of that. I didn't vlog Wallaby Hill because I was going by myself and I wouldn't have been able to get any footage. Even as it was, there's like one photo of my cross country and like no photos of anything else, which is kind of annoying, but whatever. It was still a pretty good event. There's like a recap of that on my Instagram. But we almost got a sub 30 fad dressage, so I was really happy with that. Oh, she's off. Now she's used me as a scratching post. She's done. I'm back with the liberty training voiceover. Sorry if you can hear my washing machine behind me, that's just tiny apartment problems. So just started off this morning doing some liberty circles with Arrow, just getting her like walking and trotting and focusing on me when I stick my arm up in the air, that tells her to woo. I do use my voice commands for walk, trot and canter, and if she doesn't listen to the voice command, then I might like wave the whip a little bit. She didn't want to go into Canto at the start. I don't really blame her. It was so humid this morning. We were doing this at like before 6:30 in the morning. It was still really humid. So just getting her cantering, moving her forward. I stick my arm up to say woo, and she wooed pretty good. And then I asked her to trot again, and I'm just gonna do some more of this. So she's being pretty good. She's sticking quite close to me on the circle, except when I ask her to canter, because it's hard to canter a smaller circle, obviously. At the end, she does canter some smaller circles. Again, that was a good woo. So she's listening to me, which is all I'm really doing at the start here. I also did, sorry for the washing machine, it's really loud. I also did some getting her to paw. Like, technically it's called jambette. It's like the beginning of Spanish walk. I did that at the start. So that's what that was. And now I'm asking her to come in. Arrow, as you'll see in this video, like, she's quite happy not to stand right with me. Barry's quite different. Barry wants to be like right in my space all the time, where Arrow's just happy to be somewhere nearby. So getting her to like come all the way in, she's just like, oh, I'm good, I don't really need you right next to me. Thing she got a little bit stuck on today. I had been asking her to come over to me, sort of like the beginning of targeting, but she was just like not feeling it, didn't want to come. Can't really blame her. As I said, it was so humid this morning. We'd only done about like 10 minutes of work, but still I think she was a bit over it. So now, just so we finish on a good note, I'm going to just get that trick happening. And I'm sort of going to break it down to the way that I first teach them this, or the way I first taught her this. Barry was very different. I do the thing where I get them to stand and wait and then come to me when I ask. Arrow was always very good at standing and waiting, as you can see. Barry was not. Barry took ages to get stand, wait, come when I tell you. And Arrow took ages to get come to me. So now what I'm doing is just getting her to take one tiny little step forward, and then I give her heaps of praise, I give her a tiny little bit of a treat, tell her she's a good girl, and then wait for a second, and then I take some more steps, and then I ask her to come again. And this is the part where, especially if your horse is like brand new to Liberty work, it's a lot of waiting and standing around and learning to be really, really patient, because you can't really force them to do anything. And she's just having a lick and a chew and think about stuff.
Good girl. Good job. Come on. Good girl. Good job. Good job. Mama. Come on, Mama. Good job. Good job.
Now that she's coming over when I ask her to, we're gonna have a go at that first trick again. So I call it like a wait, come here, or like it's the beginning of targeting, I guess. So I'm just gonna position her and then I put my hands up, hold the whip over my head and ask her to wait while I walk away. And then when I drop my whip to my side, she should come over, which she does, very good girl. She had done this trick fine the day before. I think it was more, it was really humid. She just wasn't in the mood, more than her not understanding what to do. Ari does like liberty training. She doesn't love it like Barry does. She's kind of happy to be doing something, but I think she'd probably rather be doing proper work than this still. I think she does like the treats and the attention still though, so we'll keep going with the liberty stuff just to keep her little brain occupied. So I think that's gonna do it for today because it's so humid and Ari looks kind of tired, don't you, honey? So we're gonna go get you your breakfast. She was a really good girl. Got a little bit stuck on that like stay come here trick. She's always been a little bit harder with that one. She's really good at the stay, not so good with the come here. Barry's really good with that one, but it took ages to get him to stay because he wants to be like right next to me all the time. Whereas Arrow's a lot more confident than Barry. So she's like, whatever, I don't really need you. So it's getting her to come because days like today when she's feeling a little bit tired, a little bit flat, she's just like, why move if I don't have to? I'm perfectly fine here. Come on, Bob, we're gonna have some breakfast. So yeah, that was kind of good in a way because then I just took it back to like the sort of beginning steps of it. So at least you could see like how you start to teach that one, I guess, or how I teach that one. Again, I'm just making this up as I go along. Not an expert. Oh, my face is so like sweaty and shiny already. Lovely. So I made these treats for Arrow because she loves them, but I've used the wrong type of oats. I used like normal rolled oats instead of quick oats and they didn't really stick together. So now it's like a pile of crumbles. She still likes them and they're like sort of healthy. So I'm gonna give her some of those. I made these to use for her trick training so I'm not having to give her like really sugary treats. But it's hard to use a thing full of like crumbles as a treat. Not ideal for keeping in one's pocket.
And she's the happiest girl for breakfast time.
I was walking down the street the other day, trying to distract myself, but then I see your face. Oh wait, that's someone.
I just did Arrow's feet with the hook oil because it's so hot and dry at the moment. So I just sprayed her feet with some water and then used this to try and seal the moisture in. And she's also got this little bit of scabbing just on the back foot here. So I'm going to use the soothing aloe vera gel on that. It has been healing up pretty well. I'm not sure where it's from. I think it's just photosensitivity. And then the nose and coconut oil through her tail, because she's been getting a little bit itchy at the top of her tail and we want to protect luscious.
I think I am getting some new products dropped off from Equiday tomorrow too, so that's exciting. Got some very groomed ponies, get to try a couple of new things. Can you see how much sweat is on my lip? Because I can feel it. Like today feels so much worse than yesterday.
great day to get hay delivered. Can't wait to move bales of hay in this awful swampy weather.
We are going to do the coconut oil during the day. Just make sure it's just going on the hair and not on their skin. Because if it gets on their skin, it might burn them when the day gets really hot.
Orange is all down for the day. She's having her breakfast and her hay. Normally I would just leave her naked because today is going to be stupidly hot. But she has acupuncture at 10, so trying to keep her a little bit clean until then. You happy girl, bub? Oh, she's very happy.
We didn't actually do too much today because it's way too hot and humid.
Now I seem a little bit tired.
So I don't know if I'm going to make this like a quick daily vlog or if I'll put them all together at the end of the week. To be decided, thinking out loud. I guess I will see how much I film the rest of the day. Might be a bit awkward filming at the vet, but I might show you like a snippet of visiting Barry and might show you some of Arrow's acupuncture. Excitement. Now it's time for me to go and get coffee. No, this is food. Just a random little OTD next to the bin. Gotta say, in love with this shirt from Cotton On. It's so light and keeps you cool, keeps the sun off, and it was super cheap too. It was like two for $25 or something crazy like that. Highly recommend. Make sure you don't get skin damage. I got coffee. I also saw a wild dog, which I was gonna try and film, but it like ran into the forest. Scary. Even the wild dog's getting hungry and thirsty. We needed to rain.
Hi! Hi, tiny pony. Oh, darling, it's so cute. Guys, we moved outside, so he's much happier about that. I went up into the, like, the hospital wing thing where he's been the last couple of days. And there was a brown horse in his stable with its back to me, and I could just see like a big bandage around its stomach, like it's had colic surgery. And I was like, what's happened? That wasn't Barry. Barry's stomach is still intact.
Hey, buddy. How many locks do you have? First, we've got this thing that lifts up and down, and it's secured by a chain. And then he has a second gate because he's an escape monster.
Hey, buddy, you're very good at opening gates.
Very good at eating carrots, too.
Molasses water and his toys. You happy, buddy?
Oh, he's a very good boy.
Okay, so just leaving vets now. Barry's doing well. And I realized I didn't really explain why Barry's in the hospital. And if you haven't seen on Instagram or you don't follow me, Barry had soft tissue damage pretty much in his foot. Bunch of reasons combined. He doesn't have the best feet to begin with, and then this year he had a puncture to his sole. Funnily enough, both my horses punctured their feet on the same day, and we have no idea on what. They were just turned out in the paddock together. They must have run around, stood on a rock, just something stupid. Arrow's healed up fine. Barry's happened to be in his bad foot that he'd already had surgery on like 6 years ago when he had an infection in his pedal bone. So his was actually looking like it was healing pretty well, but because they had to like dig out the puncture to make sure it could open up so any like infection or nasty stuff could drain out. And then as a result of that, he had to wear like a boot to cover his foot to keep the sole clean. And what that boot ended up doing is putting a bunch of pressure on the back of his heel, so it caused his heel to contract. And also, when he went back in the paddock, he ran around like an idiot because a new horse came in the paddock next to him, and he managed to slip, twist his leg, crack his splint bone in half. So that was the first setback. Then I had to have him confined again, and then he ended up walking back and forth and like pacing on really hard ground. And that combined with the contracted heel caused pretty much like tendonitis really deep inside his foot. He went to Gatton University, had an MRI, spent tons of money,
finding out what was wrong with him. And then we decided to do surgery to go in, see if that was the issue. Surgeon was really happy when he went in with how it looked before the surgery. They were pretty cautious of saying like whether he'd make like a full recovery and ever be able to come back into work again. But I decided to do the surgery anyway because it was his best shot. Surgeon was happy, cleaned out the tendon to make sure that like no scar tissue would form, give it the best chance of healing. We also injected some PRP, platelet-rich plasma, which helps boost like the growth factors to help with healing. And that was all going really well. Barry was looking really good. Arrow and I went to Wallaby Hill since he was going well. We decided that we would go to Wallaby Hill and Barry would go up the coast to the lady who does his shockwave therapy. She runs like a horse rehab up there and she has lots of racehorses as well. So she's very equipped to have a horse like Barry there, who is a bit mischievous and high maintenance. So when he was looking after Barry, he did super well. She was doing his rehab exercises and stuff for me. Then he came back and he was doing really well. And then all of a sudden last week one morning, I just found him super lame again and took him back to the vets to have a scan, see what was wrong. And his tendon has torn up higher. And what the surgeon explained is that happens sometimes when they do these sort of repairs, is all the tendon fibers are like tight, short, zip together fibers where the tendon's healing, and it puts like an uneven pressure across the tendon where there's like really like frangible sort of tissue, and then it tears up a little bit higher. So that's not that scary at the moment. As long as that heals without scarring, it should be fine still. But he was just in a lot of pain. We tried some pain medication to have him on at home, but it wasn't strong enough. So we decided to come back to the vets, have him in the hospital for a few days to have some IV pain meds and get on top of his pain, and then slowly wean him back down off of it, and then he should be able to come home hopefully tomorrow, I'm thinking. Maybe I've got to talk to the vet today and see how he thinks Barry's going. But it's a good sign that Barry's outside in that little outdoor yard now. That means like Harry must have been happy enough for him to walk down from the top stable to there, I think. Or maybe they just had a lot more like serious cases than Barry saw for it. Yeah, I don't know. I feel like I've been rambling on for a while, but hopefully Barry will be okay. The surgeon is thinking at this stage we just keep him boxed up for a couple of weeks, keep him on the pain meds, allow that tendon to settle back down again, and then keep going with his rehab that we were doing. And hopefully he'll be okay at the moment, just one thing at a time. Yeah. So now I'm going back to the barn. Arrow's gonna have her acupuncture appointment because I just like to spend all my money on horses, apparently. Because, you know, why not?
Having a big drink, hey? Got some molasses water with electrolytes, keep you hydrated. It's not that sweaty.
Oh, such round orange.
Meanwhile, I'm walking around with my backpack on, and all that's really in it is a giant water bottle. So,
is all done. She's had her acupuncture. She thinks she needs another meal. She definitely does not.
Okay, now I'm gonna go home, do some other work.
Hello.
You feeling good after your treatment?
Yeah, I think she's feeling pretty good.
You had lots of licks and twos.
She just wants more food.
Okay, goodbye.
You really don't need any more food, sweetheart. Nat saw her at Wallaby Hill like a couple of weeks ago and she's like, wow, she's really gotten a lot rounder. Doesn't take much.
Wow, good girl. Oh, darling. You're real cute. You feel good after your appointment today? Hi, honey. Hi. Had to give her a cat because that was real cute. So now we're just waiting for hay delivery to come. Hopefully that won't take too long because I feel like it might rain, which would be amazing. Let's not hold our breath. It did rain in Toowoomba last night, so might get lucky. I know you dumped your carrot. He's gone in Barry's paddock for a change of scenery. The paddocks got rotated, so she was by herself on the other side. She could still see horses, and she still had horses like near her. Now she's got her neighbours back again.